white, a bottle of red, perhaps a bottle of rosé instead. Get a table near the street, in that old familiar place, you and him face to face. Maybe a meal, something that's light. It all depends upon your appetite. Make you anything you want in a Spanish, Serbian, Egyptian, Israeli chicken and waffle restaurant. Someone will be right with you. Welcome to our friendly business!
But I guess the obvious question is, did you all come in one car? Missed the opening number, some of the character exposition, but don't worry because those three people are later than you. But that's okay, cause it's clouds in your coffee, clouds in your coffee. But she better
not be with you-know-who.
I know, Nicholas.
I can't stand the idea of her being with someone like him.
A stable boy?
A Spanish Palestinian with a Peruvian accent.
God says to love all people.
And mumble grumble.
I'm sorry?
I said mumble grumble, mumble grumble.
Don't get sassy with me. Come on, help me move in all those things out of the room and get it ready for the nurse. Okay. Come on. Come on!
Yes, I'm a man.
Okay, come on, honey.
Oh, okay. Oh, look at all the beautiful sheep in the road. Hello.
I cannot believe we finally went through with it. We did it.
It's done. And I love you more than ever.
Well, nothing
can be asked. You should be riding the donkey, you know? You need to be getting exercise. It's good for the baby.
It's still good exercise for the donkey. Hee-ha! Besides, it's more like this ass is riding me.
Hey! The only one that is best for us and our child.
Well, then help me pick a name.
I told you, we have to let the name happen. Here. Sit on these two black boxes, made you look like a veil of hate. How can you name somebody that you have never met before?
No, but we can have choices.
Yes, but what if our choices are Bashir or Netanyahu? And we meet him or her?
It's a him.
It's a him? Well, what if we meet him and he's more of a Shalom or a Borat?
No, it's just... No.
What?
It's just I want our baby to have a name like no other. I want him a kind.
Oh, like Apple.
Balthazar.
Or Blanket.
Ezekiel.
Or the situation.
Maybe we will keep working on it. Okay. I want it to be something that people will remark at because it's remarkable.
Oh, I like that. And I love you, Leticia Clausen, Herr Perlstein.
So close.
You have a very difficult last name to say.
I know, and I love you too, Manolo. But can you please try and look more presentable? My father will surely see us together.
Presentable?
Those shoes, that shirt.
Oh. She's broke with my shoes. How many nurses in the house, huh? What's the matter with the clothes I'm wearing?
Can't you tell that your shirt's a mess?
Well, maybe I should just try and untuck it.
Now it looks more like a dress. Where have you been hiding out late, honey?
Working with the banker, she still makes some extra money.
Everybody's talking about the new look, honey.
But it's still Dr. Scholl's for me.
Don't try and sweet talk me.
handsome fish of the sea. Yes, you.
Will you get my shoes and swim them over to me?
And swim them over to me.
That is the first time I've seen a fish with arms that could throw things. Oh, thank you very much, fish number two. Can you help me just put this on here for me, okay? Just right there. Like, you didn't know this was going to happen sitting in the front row, okay? If you undo the Velcro, it's easier. It's a new invention, I know. Okay, thank you very much. Do you have any communicable diseases? No? Yes, I have four of them. Okay, undo the Velcro for me, please. Nice and tight on the top one. Little tighter, please. Thank you for the tight shoes.
Why is my daughter yelling?
Well, I was yelling, sir.
You yell like a girl.
Nicholas.
Now you said yourself he yells like a girl. You twist his arm. You tell me he doesn't yell just like a girl. Get in there.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Clausen. Here. Stables. You okay? It's a hymn.
Mama, it's not fair.
Your father's a very difficult man.
Oh, he's an ass.
That's very insulting.
Yeah, glasses. I'm out of here. Yeehaw!
He's your father. He's only acting on what he feels is best for you.
But I love Manolo, Mama. He's the father of my baby, and Papa as a Papa should respect Manolo as a Papa.
Yes, I know. But give it some time.
How much time, Mama? A lifetime? I will be with Manolo forever, and I always thought we would live here with you and Papa. All together, all in the family.
Boy, do we Glenn Miller plays.
But if Papa will not support Manolo and I being together, then we may have to leave here, Mama.
Makes me so very upset that I will dance about it. Then these two, you're going crazy.
Gives him a heart attack.
Please, sir, do not pass go. Do not collect the coin.
Please do not lambast this desert queen, for as everyone knows, woman was taken out of man, not out of his head to top him, nor out of his feet to be trampled underfoot, but out of his side to be equal to him, and near his heart to be loved.
Yeah.
Three girls and one dude right there.
What are you, a wise guy?
Yeah, you all are. Three wise guys.
Sorry about the glass. It's Billy Joel's Glass Houses album. You don't hit it, boys. Never mind. Look, let me tell you why we're here, all right? Murphy, what are you doing? We got a box step on the count of 8, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, good. Let me break it down for you. Friday night I heard a story about a star in all its glory. It's supposed to mean a lot of things. It's a sign of what's to come.
Thank you.
is an angry young man, cause of Nicholas lies and his radical plan. He refuses to bend, he refuses to crawl, but he might have to crawl to clean out all the stalls. And he's proud of the fact that the baby is his, but he thinks that it shouldn't be nobody's biz. And he likes to be known as an angry young man. To the angry young Manolo, cause he'd like to express himself dancing a solo. He's been stepped in the back, he's been misunderstood. It's a comfort to know that his bottoms are good, and he thrashes about till he can't anymore. But he can't do his jazz walks across half the floor, and he likes to be known as the angry young man. Hello.
I gotta sing. Yeah, I can really go for some lip syncing.
Even Huffy is upset! my new business idea with you.
And what is that?
Oh, let me show you. Hot dog and a gun.
My weenie.
Such a sad, sad child. Manolo, come here. West Side Story?
West Bank Story.
You don't have a problem with what I'm doing, do you?
You mean selling a lie to the people and using your daughter like a sideshow attraction?
Yes. If you really want to know...
Why you speak on my lips? Don't you want to be able to give Letitia all the finest things that a woman needs? To be able to provide for her well beyond the means of an ordinary stable boy? Give young baby Nicholas all the little things that a little baby needs. Like a baby Bjorn, or a diaper genie, or a season subscription to a sports pack, something.
Well, I
we have a good thing going here, boy. The people just need something to believe in. We're just providing a means of escape. Ever since they pulled those Chilean miners out of that will.
I'm sorry, sir, the Chilean miners, they work in a mine, not a well.
Oh, I must be thinking of baby Jessica.
Oh,
okay. Oh, we need another feel-good story.
Oh, that was a feel-good story.
It's a great feel-good story.
They had all the comedians coming together to save those kids.
The comedians that had got them. And what about the one guy? When he came back up, he had the wife, and he had the poof together. Too close. So, do we understand each other?
I'm only going along for Leticia and little Manolo Jr. I want them to be well taken care of.
Well, this is your chance.
Boogity ha!
Just think about it, Manolo. Think about what it would be like for you to be able to give her all the finest things that she needs.
I can see us now. We will sign up for Manolo and me classes.
I'm coming!
No! Leave me alone, Manolo! Don't come up here! Unless you have churros!
Where's your
Janice?
Letitia! Oh! Hey! Let me in! The curtain, it's locked!
I know, I am!
Like I have not done this before. We don't have to do this, you know!
Yes, we do. They built a two-story set. We have to do something up here.
Oh, it is so long.
No, my parents are very short. They built it to spend.
Let's do it on our knees. Not this thing, but this thing with your papa and the money and our baby. You don't have to do this.
But you want me to. I saw you striking a deal with papa. And I know you. You probably had a dream sequence of some kind, like something out of Greece or Aida or Legally Blonde.
It was a terrific device.
It is. What did papa give you? A goat?
No.
A burro?
No.
Me?
I thought I already had you.
Do you have me, Manolo? Am I something to you other than a way to get rich quick?
No. No, no, this is not what I want! Let's run away. Let's run away. You and me, we can have a whole new world!
How can we now?
Say goodbye to Bethlehem. Say goodbye, my baby.
Virginia!
Yes, Your Majesty?
Virginia, do not call me Your Majesty. I am Herod, King of the one and only King of the Jews. Your Majesty makes me feel too far above all the little people. Oh my goodness, especially you. You can't see a thing, can you?
No.
Oh. Malcolm, bring your mirrors! Malcolm!
Oh, jeez, boss, what is it? My leprosy's back. I was trying to take a nap.
Give these people your mirrors there and get backstage again.
Oh, oh.
Hand them out, yes. Disperse them. Can you see me now?
Yes.
Can you see me now?
Yes.
Can you see me now? Back to the plague! Virginia, when did birth announcements make it to the top of the scroll? Wise men hail virgin birth. King of the Jews to be born to local couple. Well, I'll tell you what. The King of the Jews was born to a local couple a long time ago, and it was me. Now some girl is claiming to be the virgin mother of the unborn King of the Jews with an immaculate conception.
Immaculate conception?
Hmm.
Oh, you mean the tipped pass that Pittsburgh Steelers running back Franco Harris caught you? Playoff game against the Oakland Raiders?
No, that was the immaculate reception.
Oh, you mean when George W. Bush edged out Al Gore in the race for the presidency in the year MM?
No, that was the immaculate election.
Oh, you mean when certain individuals have the uncanny ability to read the thoughts of others without their knowledge or prior written consent?
No, that's extrasensory perceptions.
Oh, you mean the movie that everybody loved but nobody understood?
Eyes Wide Shut?
No, not that one. The one that dove into the dreams of a character played by A-list celebrity Leonardo DiCaprio.
No, that's Inception. Enough, Virginia, enough. There is one King of the Jews, me. I want you to get this girl where she breeds. I want you to find this Nancy girl local. I want her upset. I want her family upset. I want her inn badly damaged. I want to go there in the middle of the night and I want to knock on her curtain and run!
How do you mean, sir?
I mean, I want to do some really bad stuff. After intermission, I'm going to get biblical on these people. Come to the light!
Sir, please, think about what you're saying. Your actions can have a profound effect on civilization for generations to come. Are you truly considering reintroducing the concept of a 10-minute intermission into this year's trip show?
Oh, absolutely. We have to sell chip CDs. We're down to our last 800.
You're right. And they would make perfect stocking stuffers next year.
We can inform parents that some material is inappropriate for children under the age of one. So, Virginia, gather me some intel.
Bum, 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 bum.
Yes, go to the inn and tell me about the Jews. I want the lowdown on this story. There is one king of the Jews, moi.
Not to worry, sir. We already have someone on the case. Special ops. Hush, hush.
Oh, well, thank you very much, Dick Cheney. Don't tell me anything. It's all right. I'm sure you'll handle your business. Moi.
For sure, sir. Would you care to sing?
Oh, no, I couldn't possibly.
Oh, please, sir, don't make me beg.
You could beg a little bit.
Please, sir, oh, please, give it to us, baby.
No, family show. Besides, there's not enough room up here. There's only room to do this, and I want to do this!
Ow! What? Hey!
I have to save it for later when I'm the heavy and I have to bring in the noise.
I'm gonna repeat it.
Okay.
And defunct. Probably not worth repeating.
Oh, Virginia. It was worth repeating because that's why you complete me. Come here, baby. You know, maybe I will sing. Get rid of that.
Oh, you're up.
Okay. These people don't know that much about me. My bio was limited to 100 words. You can't write about someone like me in 100 words. No, can you? Can you? No, you can't. Virginia, read them a few of the passages that I was forced to leave out of my bio.
Of course, sir, of course. Matthew 2:3. When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed.
Very disturbed. Read another one.
Matthew 2:7. Then Herod called the Magi secretly.
Read another one.
Matthew 2:15. Where he stayed until the death of Herod.
What?
Where he stayed until the death of Herod.
The good book my Aunt Annie spared me. Get rid of that. Oh. Boys, let's sing a song. What have you got?
Good evening, everyone. We're going to slow it down here for a few minutes. Where are my Jews? Hands up, people. Did you get your taxes in on time? Don't make me come down there. Some folks like to get away, take a holiday from reality. Smoke them a big old bowl and rewrite some history. I may not be very funny, especially in the second act, but I'll tell you something you don't know. I'm the only factual character in this show. Yeah, you're right. Here we go. Let's kick it in, man. Come on in, the water slide. You may think that this is just a joke and that the words I've spoke are unreliable. Well, I say unto you, what you won't do, I'm in the Bible. You go look up the book of Letty, Manolo, Nicholas, and Greta, too. You ain't gonna find them, so yabba dabba do. I think I have to finish that line of nothing. I'm a king, do that problem. It weren't so easy living back in the day. Lots of floods, no weather.com. So while we listen to a super sexy solo on the saxophone, Virginia and me will dance like at a junior prom. Whoa, takes me back. Take it away, hon. Here we go. Thank you.
who took their kiddies in and preached for their Gideons. I'm not gonna trump any more names like Alexander the Great, Cleopatra, Caesar, personal friends of mine.
Excuse me, Virginia, back up, so you can go.
I'm the only real character. I'm the only real character.
Yes, there's the key. All right. I'm the only real
character you'll find. Yeah! Whoa.
Thank you very much, people. We'll see you in the second act, all right? Hey, you two, give me a wait. You didn't pay for those seats. I know you did. All right. Good night, everyone. Come on.
And said, "Daddy, I'm going to have a baby." I thought it a bit odd because she's never really had a boyfriend and we don't have a milkman. And without any further ado, I would like to introduce you to my daughter, Leticia the Miracle Mom.
Things are gonna be alright with me.
Let me have it! Come on! Take me!
been traveling for the longest time. It has been difficult keeping the faith. Settle down. I am Joseph of Arimathea, and this is my very pregnant wife, Mary. Is there any room in your inn?
Jesus!
Like the I get you some lemonade?
Sure.
Great. Small or large?
Large?
Coming up. Special blend for Mary's at the Virgin.
Can we have the baby?
I'm a little busy right now, Letty.
I know, but...
Okay, you know what? Let me just drop what I'm doing and work on your needs. Fine. Fine. I think the baby book is down here. Where did I put it? Oh, here we go.
Virgin Mary, please report to the pickup counter. Your lemonade is ready. Virgin Mary, here you go. Please recycle. Bye.
Very sweet lemonade. All right. Oh, what about Christopher? It means bearer of Christ. What's a Christ?
I don't know, but I feel like I should.
Oh, what about Mordecai? Warrior.
Oh, no, no fighting. I believe that there will be peace between Jews and Arabs any day now.
Listen, Leticia, there's something I have to get off my chest. See, I heard about what happened with the hoedown and the Miracle Mom thing and the announcement, and I just wanted to say I'm really sorry that Joseph and I showed up right when we did and ruined everything.
No, Mary. It is I who should apologize to you. We are just trying to raise money for the inn and make my father happy, but we should not have lied.
Well, God forgives all.
Well, my father is a different story.
I don't know what you mean.
Try telling your dad you're pregnant with God's child.
Oh, how did that go over?
Like a fart in a temple. But I told him, I said, Dad, this is how it ends.
Let's keep having some.
Listen up close. I'm listening.
Trying to run away from you. You see, a long time ago, the man who made me tried to run away from me, but I found him. I pulled his arms off. Don't let that happen to you, Daddy. Well, you two miracle moms, have a good night.
I'm not a miracle mom.
Maddie, you're both miracle moms to me. Oh my God, where did that come from? It's not my height. Better go find a village to pillage, what? The body of Atlas, Seneca's mind, and Brett Favre's knees.
How can you tell them that there's no room at the inn and make them sleep in the stable? That poor girl's about to pop.
I have to figure this thing out.
Figure what out? The jig is up. The only thing you can do is embrace them as your family.
That's not the only thing I can do.
What do you mean?
I mean, I'm sure that King Herod would appreciate someone stepping forward. Someone with information pertaining to a certain couple who proclaimed themselves to be the parents of the new king of Israel.
If you do that, I will never be able to look you in the eye ever again.
I should be so lucky.
I heard that. Someone will be fighting.
Oh,
could be Miley Cyrus.
Joseph!
Manolo, is that you?
Yes.
Marco!
Olo!
Marco!
Manolo!
Manolo, thank you for what you have done for Mary and I. You are a good man. Hmm?
But I will keep my distance, for you are quite stanky. Hey, Joe, I am not a good man.
What?
I took advantage of the woman that I love!
Well, isn't that how she got pregnant? Some humor to diffuse the awkwardness has only made it more awkward.
Hey, I am sorry you are forced to sleep in this stable. And all I could find were these swaddling cloths. I feel like an ass.
Oh, Manolo, it's okay. It made us very comfortable with your blankets and snuggies and access to Wi-Fi, huh? It has been especially fun to get to know your animals. This large ass likes to rear up on two legs like Bill O'Reilly, you know?
Tonight on The Factor, we discuss my face.
Why isn't your mouth working?
I'm still trying to find that string, sucker.
Who put the weenie in there on closing Wednesday night? Who did that? You have regurgitated a weenie, large ass. And it is whole, which is crazy. I don't know, you're going to pick up the weenie? Is that your weenie?
I am wearing a dance belt. My weenie is going nowhere.
I wish I didn't have that visual. Pick up the weenie. You are going to pick up the weenie. Got it. Oh. As your director, I ordered it.
Now you win all the awards.
Trust me, you won't be anyone in this town unless you touched a couple of weenies.
Okay.
No.
Show them you think you got it all under control.
Under control.
that you're dreaming. Tell her about it. Tell her all your crazy dreams. Let her know you need her. Let her know how much you need you. Tell her about it. Tell her how you think right now. You gotta tell her about it. Boy, you better get your ass together. Tell her about it. Boy, you don't wanna wait till you die. Tell her about it. Boy, 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 tell her about it.
Manolo, aren't you afraid that your ass will run away?
No, he always knows where his home is.
Tell her about it. We were the goons in the ass costume. Yeah. Tell her about it. How could we repay an old man? Tell her about it. Mama, she would be so proud of us. Tell her about it. Tulu, 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 tulu. Tell her about it.
And you won X Classic Rock. We'll check traffic next.
Right, Manolo, he always knew where his home was.
Do
you?
Manolo, we're out of
chicharrones! Whoa, I got to go, Joe.
Better go, Manolo.
Thank you!
Thank you! Oh. The management would like to apologize to any kids or adults who were adversely affected by the onstage separation of an act.
I want you to know how stupid I feel, and how sorry I am, and how much I love my beautiful, wonderful Leticia. And look, I am all packed. We can leave right away.
What is that?
It is my toothbrush.
No, you can unpack. Well, we are not going to run away. I changed my mind.
You didn't? How come?
Because everything I love is right here.
I want you to know, I will change anything that you want me to. He runs like a toddler.
She's got a way of pleasing.
Don't tell them.
She's a direct descendant of the Garden of Eden. And her parents are French, but they spend time in Sweden. And she brings out the best person that I can be. And I love that sweet face, which is so full of grace. She's always a Virgo to me.
It's to me when I'm feeling down, inspires me. At a sound, you touches me.
Shall be spanked and told not to become king of the Jews. Oh, very funny. Yes, thank you very much. All right. Forget it. It's too wordy. Unenforceable. Let's see. Option two would go something like, I, Herod, king of the Jews, do hereby decree that all, well, Jewish males between the ages of 0 and, say, 2, so we cover our bases, shall be banished. Banishment is good. Banished to the public schools in California. No. Come on. After 13 years of tater tots and 40 kids to a room, they'd be lucky to get a job at Burger King, let alone be a king. No. That's silly. Scratch it. Option three will kill him. Yes, this is the part in that tour. I'm not that funny. Good. We'll do it. Virginia, take a decree. I, Herod, king of the Jews, do hereby decree that all Jewish males between the ages of 0 and 2 shall be smote upon the head, yea, verily unto death. Yes, stick that in your WikiLeaks, all right? Let's get this show on the road. King of the Jews coming down. Oh, shoot. Could you just grab that sign? Oh, so much. Thank you. Wow. Oh, that gets hot fast. You can keep that. That's a little memento. Oh, good. Well, Virginia, it's time. Where's my army? I'm not going out alone. Oh, there he is. Well, if you don't ask, I won't tell, all right? Good. Oh, there she is, a mommy. Get the big thing. Come on, Virginia, don't make me wait. It might have already happened, I might be too late. Oh, but sooner or later it comes down to fate. I'm gonna find the chosen one. Well, I build him a statue and I told them to pray. I'm not gonna let them just take that away. Oh, but I never told them the price that they pay. Number one, only the boys and I. That's what I said. Only the boys and I. Only the boys and I. You sent your special ops out on a special ops operation.
the truck. Only the boys die young. That's what I said. Only the boys die young. Only the boys die young. Only the boys die young.
Chasing everyone, and he is in sunglasses and has no pants on. Oh, can I help you? Oh, would you like to rent a reindeer for the day?
Speak with this Mary.
I'm sorry, but she is resting right now.
This bullpucky boy, stand aside.
Oh. Is there a problem?
You bet your sweet patootie there's a problem. I desire access to Mary.
She's not to be disturbed. Perhaps I can deliver a message.
Maybe I can deliver a message to King Harry. A message that would surely spell doom on your little operation here.
I don't appreciate your threats. Do not call me Shirley.
Well, I intend to do something about this.
Exactly what do you intend to do?
I'm going to write that letter. You're not going to like it.
I picked him up at the lamb shelter over there on Riverside Drive right next door to Zanku Chicken. Trust me, it wasn't easy getting him past that restaurant. Apparently his name is Bobby. Cute, isn't he cute? Look at that. What? Some androgynous old shepherd dropped him off there a couple of months ago. If you didn't see Withersail, none of this is making any sense. Moral of the story, don't miss a troop show. Come on, Bobby, let's get going. Oh, look. It's a mirror. Let's go check ourselves out, Bobby. Wait a minute. Bobby, why can't I see your reflection in the mirror? Bobby, are you a vampire? Wait a minute! That's not a mirror! That's a hologram! Let's walk through it. Oh! Wait a minute! That's not a hologram! And that's not a mirror! That's my avatar! That's not my avatar, and that's not a hologram, and that's not a mirror. Who the are you?
Run for the hills or fit into fang!
Such commitment for a 5-second character.
What's that?
My script! Somebody bring me my script!
flushed.
Can I get you something to drink?
Goodness, I would love some lemonade.
Oh my God, a hoffy makes the greatest lemonade. Hoffy!
Now who didn't see that coming, huh? Oh, here's Scrivener. It clearly states the real Winter Warlock. Thank you, Harpo Marx. Now, where's your script?
Well, hey, what's that?
What?
I learned that from Bugs Bunny.
Bunny, stealing my bed. Get the heck out of here, you fakey. I can't believe that guy. Wait a minute. Don't I know you? Aren't you in the new movie with Christian Bale and Mark Wahlberg? You play the dad to Mark Wahlberg. What's the name of that movie? What, the Boxer?
The Fighter.
That's you, right?
Yes.
For me, gathering intel.
Bum, 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 bum.
But now, his work is done and it's time to pay the piper.
Again, what's the commitment?
It'd be nice if she could learn a song though, wouldn't it?
I happen to know that there are two mummies to be among you. So, Mr. Innkeeper, if that's your real name, if you know what's good for you, if you want to keep your life and your inn, you'll do the right thing and hand them over. Oh, wait a minute. I know you.
Isn't that new movie with Marky Mark Wahlberg?
Palestinian High, class of XVII.
Pally High?
You are voted most likely to become king of the Jews.
And you were voted most likely to be the character who stands up to the antagonist at the crucial moment of Act Two in a holiday musical in Toluca Lake.
But actually, it's Burbank adjacent. Stand back, Herod, and let me fulfill my destiny. Hit it, boys!
You brought your boy toy with you, looking for kids in his school. Yeah, when you woke up this morning with this sick idea, I bet you never.
I give you permission to marry my daughter.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Klaus and Robin Oppenstein.
You got it right.
Actually, we are already married.
What? It's true, Mama. It happened this morning.
You mean to tell me that my grandchild will not be born a bastard?
No. He will have my name. Ahmadinejad.
From now on, there will always be room at my inn.
costumes, but different.
Unique. Look, I'm working on Cat's Cradles.
And we decided to name him Joel. Like Joel, but different.
Unique.
The first ever Jesus.
And the first Joel.
Yeah!
Sing along, then we will let you go.